Crooked Man is a nasty British spook. He's a tall man dressed like a gentleman wielding an umbrella that he likes to hook people with. The unnerving figure crops up in the Conjuring movies, but if we delve even deeper, he is also peppered in folklore. What does this mean? Could the stories of the Crooked Man have any truth to them? And if so, what does that even mean? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that loves providing answers to everything and anything from science, history, philosophy, pop culture, and fiction. Why? Because curious minds make interesting people. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today we're asking, what if the Crooked Man was real? Before we get into this video, why don't you guys let me know which fictional character scares you the most? I personally cannot handle the Babadook. He terrifies me, unless he's at Pride, in which case, I'm kinda here for him. Let me know who and what you find the scariest in the comments section down below, and also while you're down there, why don't you leave a thumbs up on this video and share it with a friend? And if you want to connect with anyone that went into making into this video, there are links to socials in the description box. Alright, Crooked Man, what you got for us? So the character in question here comes from the Conjuring movie franchise and is seen in The Conjuring 2 as a formation of the demon Valak. The Crooked Man is mainly taken from English folklore and nursery rhymes used to enhance the movie's British setting. The Crooked Man is tall and menacing and inhabited by a shape-shifting demon. He carries an umbrella which seems all the better for hooking you with, and he bears some strong similarities with Slender Man. So, what if he was real? Well, like, maybe he is. Some news for you guys, but The Conjuring 2 is based on a true story. The movie brings to the screen the real-life case of Ed and Lorraine Warren, who investigated a house in Enfield, England, after it was reported that a poltergeist was haunting. While the movie has a shred of truth at its core, unfortunately, or actually probably fortunately, it doesn't extend to the Crooked Man, who comes from an old English nursery rhyme. Now, it was said that he was simply placed in the movie to accentuate the setting. Although, good news for Crooked Man lovers, he is getting his own spin-off movie like The Nun, so perhaps you'll find out a little more about him there. So what about this nursery rhyme he's from then? Is there any truth to that? Let's have a listen. There was a crooked man, and he walked a crooked mile. He found a crooked sixpence upon a crooked stile. He bought a crooked cat, which caught a crooked mouse, and they all lived together in a little crooked house. Creepy. A few places do lay claim to the origin of the rhyme. The sleepy and pretty village of Lavenham in Suffolk, also the basis for Godric's Hollow in Harry Potter. Here the houses are old and pretty wonky, but that seems to be the bottom line creep of it. Also laying claim to the rhyme, some say that the Crooked Man himself was the Scottish general Alexander Leslie, who secured political freedom for Scots in the 17th century. Nonetheless, it wasn't him that was crooked, but the tempestuous relationship between England and Scotland. Okay, but like in The Conjuring, what would happen if that version of the Crooked Man was real, the real spook? Well, this would mean that the demon Valak, the Marquis of Snakes, the Defiler, and the Profane is real, which has some wider implications about the existence of demons as a whole. Valak is known as the Great President of Hell in mythology, which basically makes him the devil or something similar in terms of the embodiment of evil. Ed Warren manages to banish Valak back to Hell, so perhaps we could get rid of the Crooked Man by means of a demonologist or an exorcism of sorts. The problem is, with Valak and the Crooked Man, seeing as they're one of the same, is that they're shapeshifters, so we would never necessarily be able to yield the rewards of a wanted poster. The Crooked Man could be hiding as anything and everything, for example a dog like in the movies. We would need expert eyes and opinions of a demonologist to even be able to seek the demon. Sounds like a lot of effort. Annoyingly, the demon can give people terrible sick visions, which frankly, we could all just live without. Aren't we just trying to make it through the day? We wouldn't know what is real and what isn't, which would be detrimental to our mental health. Basically, we would all go a bit crazy if surrounded by the Crooked Man. Get out of here, sir. How would we even begin to fight the demon if we had to anyway? Say it was gonna take a while for a demonologist to show up and we needed to defend ourselves. Basically, I'm thinking one thing here. Umbrella duel. Can you even call yourself a successful British person if you don't engage in a good brawly battle? I note that the Crooked Man also has little glasses. Are they for show, or could we knock those off his creepy smiley face? Would he then be impeded? Could he even see us to get us? I honestly hope that that would defeat him. If all else fails though, I'd simply recommend moving somewhere decidedly unrainy like the south of California, or the desert. What business does a suit-wearing, umbrella-carrying spook have in the desert? None. Honestly, none. Whereas Whereas perhaps wet places like good old London or, say, Seattle, they may be the perfect climate for the Crooked Man, so I would avoid at all costs. So the Crooked Man may not be real, but he does share a lot of similarities with similar legends. The Japanese tale of Noparera Bo, the German De Grossman, and the English character of Long Lambkin. Oh, and once again, the popular urban legend of Slender Man. If all of these cultures can dream up a tall, thin creep, do you think that they could be different incantations of the same thing? Or are their similarities a coincidence? It must say something about the human psyche that so many of us have invented a reason to be scared of a tall, thin, and silent man. Do you think that maybe, like the Loch Ness Monster or the Sasquatch, there could be a tall, thin, suit-clad creep waiting to get us? If so, what would you do? Why don't you let me know in the comments section down below? For now, we will have to wait for the Crooked Man movie to find out more about this demon. Until then though, why don't you leave me your thoughts and comments in the comments section down below? Don't forget to let me know which fictional character scares you the most. I am all ears. For now, I'm your host Rebecca Felge, I'll catch you in the next video. Until then, stay curious, stay away from tall, creepy, crooked men, and never ever stop questioning.